Interoception is a word that you may or may not have heard being used a lot recently. It's been around for a while, but we're really understanding its impact on human development more and more with the recent research that's coming out. Interoception is your sense of inner well-being, your sensations from inside your body. And so it might be, it's a number of things. It might include how fast your heart is beating, your breathing, whether you're hungry or have butterflies in your tummy, your gut, what your gut is doing or not doing, whether or not you need to go to the restroom. All of these different things count as interoception. And as I said, what we're realizing and the research is really supporting now is how critical this sense is for human development. I'm Virginia Spielmann. I'm the executive director here at Star Institute for SPD in Colorado. And today we're talking about interoception. Hundreds of years ago, they passed out interoception from exteroception from proprioception. So interoception are those internal sensations. What are the organs of your body doing? What's happening internally? All those signals that you should be getting that tell you about your well-being. Exteroception would be anything external, anything from the outside world, but you can get visual information about that and so on. And then proprioception is often used to refer to one sensory system, but also in this context, really refers to your sense of body position and movement in space. And so perhaps on another day we'll talk about visual proprioception and what that means. But today we're looking at interoception really partly because of how central it's coming to our understanding of the contribution of sensation to health and well-being in every domain. And we're realizing more and more that this is across diagnostic categories, across demographics and populations, and that we need to really have a generalized understanding of this in multiple environments and professions. And so that internal sense of well-being that you need to be able to read in order to meet your needs, your basic hierarchy of needs, tiredness, how stressed your body is at any one time, your heart rate, your respiration, do you need to take a break, do you need to have a drink? It also tells you if you're having a physiological response to threats, and we really need to be attuned to those well. It also could be pleasure sensations that we need to be able to register. And even as an infant, you know, it's important that we get that data so that we know we're in a nurturing, loving situation with a caregiver who's reliable and stable, as well as the importance of being able to register pleasurable sensations and sensual sensations in adulthood for obvious reasons. And so this interoceptive system is something that we haven't really been able to look at, we haven't really been able to explore, and more now we're finding what it means when it goes awry, when it's disordered. So disordered interoceptive information or interoceptive information that cannot be well integrated by an individual seems to really contribute to panic disorders, anxiety disorders, depression, there's somatic disorders and other areas, even acting out and so on, behavioral challenges. And so we start to see that this needs to be part of evaluations. It needs to be part of what is considered when a child presents with difficulty developing functional behaviors, adaptive behavioral responses. And again, what we're saying is when you see something maladaptive and that might be labeled as a misbehavior, instead of just saying, let's extinguish the behavior, we're saying, consider whether there's a contributor here from the sensory systems, in this case, that interoceptive sense of how I'm doing in the world. Obviously, children with challenges with interoception who are under-responsive to it, they might have problems with toilet training. They might overeat. They might think something is worse than it is or isn't as bad as it is, and then have poor responses to risky situations, poor risk assessment skills. And so learning about interoception, finding out about this sensory system that seems to be a little bit of a buzzword at the moment, is actually really important because of how it contributes to mental health and behavioral challenges, to these disorders that we would call panic disorders and anxiety disorders and so on. So have a look at the website if you want to ask more questions. Put something in the comment box if you want more information or you have a request for a Facebook video next time. See you soon.